Good afternoon.
Afternoon, John.
Please remember to take a moment and silence your cell phones. This Friday, June 7th, we will be having Eucharistic Adoration at 7 p.m. Friday. On Thursday, June 13th, we will pray the Rosary in the Peace Garden. And Father Benny will be gone to the Pesbyteral Assembly from Monday until Thursday evening. Please pray for the priests of the Archdiocese, including our newly ordained priest.
Good afternoon and welcome.
Good afternoon.
I'm going to begin today with number 312, Table of Plenty, number 312.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, all my dear brothers and sisters.
Good evening.
As a part of appreciation and praising God for the wonderful blessings showered upon us, especially that we offer 10 families for the prayers and a great support and stewardship that they have given to this church and for their own families and our families. We pray and offer these families today as a part of the 15th anniversary of the Mary Queen of Peace Church. They are Sabarina Nali,
Stephanie.
I should not forget that anyway. Nali. Gray and Angela Noort. Judd Noort. Sorry if I mispronounce again. Joe and Emily Noort. Joe and Kathy Noort. Pat Catherine Noort. Bill and Mary Ann Nelson. Kathy Neuner. Joe and Reva Nevitt. We are here to celebrate the sacred mysteries, and we know today is the solemnity of the most holy body and blood of Jesus Christ, the Corpus Christi. Let us have a worthy celebration by asking blessing from our wonderful God. Lord Jesus, you gave us your body and blood as the strength of our journey of conversion. Lord, have mercy.
Lord
Jesus, you blessed us with your Son who sacrificed his body and blood for our redemption. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you came in word and sacrament to bring peace to our people. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
We glorify you. We glorify you.
O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who lives and reigns with the God the Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. When Moses came to the people and related all the words and ordinances of the Lord, they all answered with one voice, "We will do everything that the Lord has told us." Moses then wrote down all the words of the Lord, and rising early the next day, he erected at the foot of the mountain an altar and 12 pillars for the 12 tribes of Israel. Then, having sent certain young men of the Israelites to offer holocausts and sacrifice young bulls as peace offerings to the Lord, Moses took half of the blood and put it in large bowls. The other half he splashed on the altar. Taking the book of the covenant, he read it aloud to the people, who answered, "All that the Lord has said, we will heed and do." Then he took the blood and sprinkled it on the people, saying, "This is the blood of the covenant that the Lord has made with you, in accordance with all these words of his." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, when Christ came as high priest of the good things that have come to be, passing through the greater and more perfect tabernacle not made by hands, that is, not belonging to this creation, he entered once for all into the sanctuary, not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls and the sprinkling of a heifer's ashes can sanctify those who are defiled so that their flesh is cleansed, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God, cleanse our consciences from dead works to worship the living God? For this reason, he is mediator of a new covenant. Since a death has taken place for deliverance from transgressions under the first covenant, those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Of the unleavened bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, Jesus' disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?" He sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the city, and a man will meet you, carrying a jar of water. Follow him, wherever he enters. Say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room, where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' Then he will show you a large upper room furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there." The disciples then went off, entered the city, and found it just as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. While they were eating, he took bread and said the blessing, broke it and gave it to them and said, "Take it, this is my body." Then he took up a cup, gave thanks and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." And after singing a hymn, they went out to to the Mount of Olives. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Corpus Christi is the celebration of the abiding presence of a loving God as Emmanuel, God with us. In our Lord is living with us in the Eucharist. The last two precious gifts given to us by Jesus are the Holy Eucharist as our spiritual food on Holy Thursday, and Jesus' mother, Mary, as our spiritual mother on Good Friday. Right after the consecration and the Eucharistic prayer, where the celebrant says, "This is my body and this is my blood, receive it." And he genuflects and sing or say the prayer, "The mystery of faith." Well, what is the mystery of faith? The mystery of faith is the mystery of redemption. He is here on this table. On this table that we do the sacrifice of Jesus Christ today and every day. So, the Gospel tells the details, how Jesus converted this ancient ritual into a sacrament and a sacrifice. Instead of the lamb's blood, which we read in the first reading, Jesus offered his own divine human body and blood. And instead of sprinkling us with blood, Jesus put it into our hands as food and drink. It is his own body and blood. Take and eat. This is my body, which will be given up for you. And this is my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Well, as we celebrate the solemnity of the most holy blood and body of Jesus Christ, I am remembered of a story shared by one of the presidents of India, Abdul Kalam. Is the name of that president. One family approached him by some influence, asking the president to help them because their child was having a serious problem in her heart. So doctors examined, after all analysis, they said, "This is incurable, this is impossible that the child may live long." Then when the president suggested a famous doctor in India to help them, they also gone through all the test results and papers, and he said, "Oh, this is impossible, this is not easy as it is written already by all the analysis and tests." But for the satisfaction and for their sake, this doctor was ready for the last attempt of a heart surgery for this girl child. Well, doctor was like not very optimistic, but still he was there with all the praise. And he told the parents, "I'm not sure, I may do this operation. And if I fail, maybe you'll take it as the will of God. Are you ready?" And they said, "Yes, let's do it." And then he thought, "I may talk to the girl." And he came to that girl and asked and told her, "You should pray and you should know that we are going to do this operation, maybe our good God will help us. But the child was having a very strange and different question. And she asked, "Can I ask you something? A favor?" "Yeah, tell me, my dear. When you do an open heart surgery, you may just look for something. My mom used to say, Jesus Christ is there in your heart. So when you open the heart, just look for him. And tell me how he looks like." Well, maybe the first or second or third stage of the operation, the doctor came to know, I mean, there is no possibility of a life. There is no pumping of blood into the heart. So he was almost left and was there praying, "God, I failed. If you can do something, do it now." But before that, he remembered, "Well, this girl has asked me about Christ. So shall I have a look there to see if Christ is there?" And he was looking for. He could not see any. He was staring like that. And maybe for the last moment, he was about to go from there and he could see one drop of blood coming or dipping there to the heart by the artery. And he was surprised to see that drop of blood. And that was enough for him. And it is said that child was saved by after that. Well, after days, when the child was in good conscience and everything, he came back to the room and he could not control himself. There were tears in his eyes by seeing the happiness of the child, the parents, and he hugged them and came up to the child, and he never expected that child still remember the question she asked. And the first question she asked, "Doctor, did you see Christ in my heart? What is the shape and how he looks like?" And the doctor said, "I don't know, my dear. This time, Christ was in the form of a drop of blood. That's the only thing I could hear there. I mean, see there." My dear friends, I don't know how far this connected to the Corpus Christi solemnity celebration, but I always feel that drop of blood of Jesus Christ, the body of Christ that we receive every day, is the shape of Christ, and that's what he is looking like. And that's what is giving us life. The moment we receive the body and blood of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. And you are ready for heaven. Now, today, when you do that reception of the body and blood of Jesus Christ, what other gift we may get from? I don't know. Well, let us ask God to feel that real presence. As I always remember, Elizabeth, cousin of Mother Mary. So, Mother Mary and John the Baptist in her womb was leaping, jumping by the presence of Jesus Christ in Mother Mary's womb nearby. Well, so we all have the presence of Jesus Christ here and every day when we offer Holy Mass. Let us have the grace and blessing of God to realize that presence and the awareness of the great gift that we are receiving every day from this Holy Eucharist. All please stand up and offer our prayers and needs and profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. For all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, and substantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He'll come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Mindful that Christ is the vine and we are the branches, we present these prayers to our sustainer and our hope.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That the Church, the sacrament of unity, will draw all believers to know the real presence of Christ in the Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations all over the earth renew their commitment to peace and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those with doubts or whose faith has wavered be strengthened and lifted by this sacred mystery. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who share the Eucharist with the elderly and the homebound be blessed with patience, loving hearts, and an appreciation of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful of our community grow in appreciation of and participation in adoration and Eucharistic devotion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving, we especially pray for the families of Sabrina Nally, Stephanie Nally, Gary and Angela Nart, Jared Nart, Joe and Emily Nart, Joe and Kathy Nart, Pat and Catherine Nart, Bill and Mary Ann Nelson, Kathy Nooner, Joe and Reva Nevitt. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of Bill, Mildred, Catherine, and Jason Abel, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, you offer your beloved Son in the sacrament of the Eucharist. Hear and answer our prayers as we celebrate this Eucharistic feast. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Number 326, the Body of Christ. Number 326.
Miracle of the greatest of all.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we hear present through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished lamb, an acceptable gift of the perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them only holy so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. So we approach to the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all the creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song of adoration as we, with all hosts of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and bread of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Shelton, our bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should be my Lord, but only my soul shall. The body and blood of Jesus Christ may keep us safe for eternal life.
Number 339, The Supper of the Lord, number 339.
Yeah.
As we celebrate the birthdays, anniversaries, before that, I would like to share with you, as we all know, the Archdiocese today have five more newly ordained priests. There were three bishops for the ordination, service and the sacrament and the mass today, and five new priests are there. So let us pray for more vocations and thank God for a wonderful priest ordained in our Archdiocese. I would like to see the members or families who celebrate their birthday in the month of June. Please stand up. We have a good number of people in the month of June. Let's start from him. You say your name and the date of your birthday, please. June 18th. Wow, that's great. Yes. June 10th. So you, here goes the card and the rose flower for you. Happy birthdays. Yeah, please. June 4th, it's this week, I mean, yes. June 10th, Charlie, wonderful, yes. June 15th, yes.
June
23rd, yeah, that's great. I mean, as such, we have so many in the month of June. 25th, oh, good, yes, please. June 4th. Okay, one more we have. Anyone from there? Oh, well, let's wish a happy birthday, all my birthday boys and babies. Great. It'll be a great blessing on this particular birthdays and all the days in your life. Thank you for everything that you are doing for your family and for the church. May God bless you all. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, thank you. Be seated, please. And do we have anniversary celebrating couples or single here in the month of November? Yes. Oh, sorry. How come November? I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Yeah, well, June. Yeah. All together, just came November. Yes. You may say your name and your wife's name if... you are okay with saying the date and how many years of marriage, please? Wow, that's great. So, that's great anniversary of marriage. Yes. 38 years. Wow. Happy anniversary. Well, do we have anyone from there? Yeah, there are. Yeah, please.
Peter and Carl Durbin, June 19th.
Oh, 22 years.
Yes. Terry and Bob Riley, June 19th, 42 years.
Very good. What a happy thing to hear that. I mean, wonderful. So, thank you and thank our God, good God, for the wonderful sacrament of marriage, love and happiness of family and all the blessing. May God bless you and continue the showers of blessing on your life. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you so much. Please be seated. Well, I was watching the soccer games in our ground these days. I was thrilled to see that how wonderfully our children are playing there, boys and girls. How many of you were there? I don't know, many of you. I mean, we were like, come on, do it now, kind of, and you know, I think along with all the training, practices, enthusiasm, their hard work, of course, we should appreciate them and their parents, grandparents, teachers. Wow. Good, wonderful. the job and was so nice to see that all of them are gathering here in our grounds. So I think there were 27 soccer games this year in our ground. I mean, this. That's wonderful altogether. Yeah. So congratulations. And a few more games are there. Maybe the finals. So if you are interested, come. Let's have some, camera is on. I cannot say a beer or something. Otherwise, let's celebrate the soccer, game here. I would like to tell about the garden also. Few many were there together. We were filling those buds, beds, raise the beds, and maybe planting day, then watering day. So some of you have already given tomato plants and other hose, maybe some shovel or whatever instruments or things needed. One by one is coming up there. Mother Mary statue, and sometimes we just water. Someday we don't see anyone there. So someday I do that. That's okay. I'm happy. I always just do that with the remembrance of my dad, because he was a farmer. Every time when I just take any of those work, I say, my dear dad, I remember you, because he was there in the farm, and I get a good chance. Now, I would suggest when I just give water, if someone is there, we talk and happily we give water to these plants. That's a wonderful occasion. If you come, let's sing a song and do it together. Are you getting the point? Maybe morning one time or evening another time. Come, let's sing some country songs and, maybe water those plants, and it's coming up good. So it'll be another occasion after our Eucharistic celebration here in the Peace Garden there, or in the soccer field there, or whatever program you plan here. Well, it's happy occasion that God give us such wonderful treasures, assets here. Let us celebrate it in a special way in this day of the body and blood of Jesus Christ. Not only that we share on the table there, we are participating that, the part and parcel of the body of Jesus Christ, each one's face, each one's life, we are sharing that. And that's the beauty of this family. So let us celebrate it as much we can in the form of garden work or whatever that comes. All right, let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace and glorify our Lord by our life.
Number 545, O God beyond all praising. Number 545.